the last of the story of Pokemon Platinum. Completely forgot the word story there. Yeah, and in between now and the last episode, I ventured into Wayward Cave to go find Mira and escort her out of there because of reasons which you may see in an episode or two of time. But in this episode, Battle Frontier ahead, and that's precisely where we're gonna head. Welcome to the Battle Frontier. This is your first visit? Right this way, please. Now, which one of these six women is saying it? Oh, you have a Versus recorder. How nice. We upgrade these recorders for first-time visitors for use. I'll borrow yours for a moment. And yeah, basically, it gets upgraded so you can record battles from the Battle Frontier. Yay. I do not have any general questions about this. Like she said, there are five facilities in the Battle Frontier, each of them following their own rules. Now, I believe at the... Oh, these stalls, you can... Right. Ooh, it just got darker. Right, at each battle facility, if you battle enough and win battles, you earn battle points, which can be exchanged at these three booths for different items. Yes, blah blah blah. This one has film scratch-off tickets, which have like special prizes on them. This one has basically things for effort values and a few battle items, like a few really good ones in there. I feel like this one's the one for TMs, maybe? It is, right, okay, cool. You can get some pretty nice ones in there. And I don't know which order I'll be doing these in, but I think I'm going to start off going to this one right here. This top right one, I guess, which I believe I'm at the right one, is the Battle Factory. Win consecutively with rental Pokemon. Whee! Now, I'm going to be saving my favourite facility for last, just because it is my favourite facility, and yeah. Right, welcome to the Battle Factory. I am your guide to single and double challenges. These challenges are designed for a single trainer, which is me. I'm going to go with double battle just because I prefer them over single battles, and I shall go for the level 50. Oh yeah, that's how many Pokemon I've seen and the playtime of this. Cough, cough. Yeah, open level basically just means you can enter them at any level, but like all of the opponents, it's either they'll be equal to your highest level or just level 100. I forgot how long this saving would take. Yikes. Now what I think I'm gonna do is have like maybe two facilities per episode and then have the Battle Tower as its own final one. Right. So I think I'm gonna battle in this facility up until either I win, like win the round, or like get to 10 minutes. I've done a bit of research on your next opponent. We can expect to see a Dratini executing Sableye. Right, yeah, so basically, we get given 6 random Pokemon to choose from. So we've got a Yanma, a Beautifly, a Totodile, a Grimer, a Krabby, and oh yikes, these are not great. Right, you can look at the summary. Oh good, you can just look at them like this, okay, that makes it a bit better, right? Yanma got a Lax Incense, which I believe is, it lowers the foe's accuracy. Ooh, actually, they're not bad, those stats. Ooh, that Yanma's pretty good. Oh wait, can't use held items, it doesn't matter, it's got silver powder. Oh, that's not great. Also, that's not great either. Oh, that's a supporting Pokemon. I kind of want to go for both the Yanma and the Beautifly, but they're both bug flying types. Sorry, let's start. I think I'm gonna go with the Beautifly. Yeah, they've both got these attacks. I'm gonna go with the Beautifly just because it's a little bit better. Right, there's a Dratini, Execute, and a Sableye. So, I have not been given very good Pokemon here, because these two are both pretty garbage. Oh, it's got Vice Grip? Oh my gosh. You know what, screw it. I'm just going to take this Yammer as well, and then I'll take this Totodile, why not? Two bug flying types and a water type. Oh my goodness. Hopefully we'll get the opportunity to switch out our Pokemon. So then I'll switch out one of the bug flying types. In romance, fashion, and Pokemon, today's girls want it all. Yes, I believe it's 7 battles in a row that you need to win. But yeah, you need to win a predetermined like amount of battles, and then you win a certain amount of BP. That's about as simple as it is. Right, so I think I kind of want to just go for the dual Ek. No, I don't. I think I'll go for the dual Silverwind. Just on the fact that Execute isn't it part Psychic as well as Grass? So at least I can take it down in like one turn for definite. Nice. Plus with Silverwind there's always that 10% chance of all my stats being raised, which is never a bad thing. Ooh, nice as well. Oh, Thunderwave, that's gonna get problematic. It could get problematic, I suppose. But honestly, since Yammer and Beautifly have very similar stats, I feel like we can take down that Dratini no problem. So I'm just gonna go for the double Silverwind as well. Or again, as well. What did I say as well? Hey, nice one, Yammer. Right, and then Beautifly. Sableye using a Faint Attack. Ooh, on Yammer who just raised his defense, which is, good lord, that would have been very damaging if, well, obviously if the defense didn't get raised. Ah, so close, right. I think I'll just use Silverwind and I'll try the Ekata this time, why not? If Yammer doesn't KO the, although, I was going to say if Yammer doesn't KO this, it'll get KO'd itself anyway. Yay, did being greedy end up costing me everything? Now, obviously, as you, increase, the number of wins you rack up, the Pokemon and trainers are obviously going to get harder. Sure, right, you can expect Cecile, Cyndaquil, and Phanpy. Right, so I think Phanpy is going to be a bit of a stalemate without your Pokemon. Seal, it's got the potential for Ice-type moves, so that could be basically both of them. Yes, let's see if we can trade. Right, summary, good, right. I know Yammer's faster, but it doesn't hit as hard as Beautifly does, so I'll exchange the Yammer. I can't even look at their summary. There was Cyndaquil, Seal, and Phanpy. I could take the Execute in hoping that it's got a grass type move to help take down Seal. Actually no, I'll take the Sableye because I feel like it might be a bit tougher. And plus it'll take away the advantages that they have over me. Either way, I think I'm in a pretty bad position. When I enter a battle, I picture the vast sea in my mind. Right. Now, I did say I'd stop, each thing in about 10 minutes, but if this one goes a little bit over, it doesn't really matter. Right, I'll Mega Drain Seal, and then Faint Attack. Nice. Fake out. Let's fake out the Cyndaquil just so it can't hit Beautifly with any fire type attacks. Wait, that Seal knows fake out as well? Oh my goodness, no. barely anything. I was hoping that I'd do decent damage. Right, let's actually just look at the stabilized summary. Oh wow, not bad. Wow, that is pretty good. Right, so I think... Wait, what was my other Pokemon? Honestly, I think it may be worth switching Totodile in. Just for safety and backup, and then I shall use Faint Attack on that seal because it can... Well, it should hit pretty hard at Pokemon. Right, I'm assuming this Ice Shard's gonna hit Totodile? Yes, right. I made a good call. I'm assuming Flame Wheel is this also gonna hit Totodile? Yes, right. Let's hope we don't get burnt. Oh, thank goodness. Right. Perfect. Cyndaquil and Phanpy? Alright, okay, so Totodile, you can just dive on Phanpy, and I may as well just Faint Attack the Cyndaquil. Ooh, the Cyndaquil's got a Quick Claw. And it Quick Clawed with Swift. Alright, I mean, maybe not personally what I would have done, but hey, what do I know? You're an AI. Cyndaquil down as well. Ooh, it missed the Rock Tomb. And just for the sake of it, I may as well just Faint Attack this Phanpy. Yep, that's fine. Didn't anticipate that I'd do much damage just because I know Phanpy has about 10 star higher defense than special defense. But anyway. That's not the point, we've defeated Kiefer. Now I think this is where I'm going to end the Battle Factory challenge. And then, let's retire from this challenge. Yay! Hopefully it doesn't take like 30 seconds to save all this data. Nice, it didn't, it only took like 7. Okay, thank you. Ooh, slow down. Why, Jesus. Right, so what I'm gonna do is, once this has stopped freaking out, well, I think I'm just gonna cut to being, like, by my next choice of battle facilities. So I've decided on the next battle facility we're gonna do, and it is the Battle Hall. Let each Pokemon seek number one. I figured this one would be okay because the other one ran a little longer than I wanted it to. So, I figure we can just do this Battle Hall because it's... From what I remember, the Battle Hall is just a really quick one, right? But for this one, just to make life easier, I'm just going to take the single challenge. Now, I believe in this, you only enter one Pokemon. So, I'm going to enter Janelle, and she will be our number one, I guess. Yes, right, let's overwrite this. Thankfully, since I've just saved, like, I don't know, about a minute or two ago. There we go, it doesn't take too long. Right, now, in my PC, there were a few Pokemon, I say a few, there's like three. Well, we should have used one of the Pokemon that I got specially for this. Oh, right. Yes, the Battle Hall is, basically, you're taking one Pokemon, you get to choose what, like, type of Pokemon you want to battle. And then I believe it's like, it's either 7 or 10 choices per round, but I don't know. But our first opponent is a level 44 Lotad. Right, and I just chose Water because Thunderbolt, but honestly, since it's a Lotad, it would have been more beneficial, I believe, to have used Fly. But anyway, that doesn't matter. Janelle got the KO. Just like that, we've won a battle in the Battle Hall. Right, now. Yay, fully restored, right? Yep, I'm ready for battle number 2. Now, as you can see, Water has moved up to rank 2. So it's every time you defeat a rank of Pokemon, I guess, of type, it goes up in rank. obviously. So, this water Pokemon, Kaden should have a slightly stronger water look. Okay, so rank 2 goes up a singular level, nice. Alright. Huh. Oh well. Now, since these are usually just either a 1-on-1 single battle or a 2-on-2 single, 2-on-2 single battle, it's probably more beneficial to have a Pokemon that's like a grass kind of type, in that it hits fast and it hits hard. I'd say usually going for the one-hit KOs are usually the better option. Right, now don't worry, I'm not gonna just exclusively choose water types. I just want to see how high we can take this. Oh dear. Right, collect a Leroy. Ooh, moving up to the Lombre now. Right, I don't think it'll be able to do that much damage to us, even if we are just using Thunderbolt. And I saw that little bit of slowdown there with the Thunderbolt animation. Where are you playing that game? Yay! I threw the match for a start. It's nice to something on Burmese. Hooray, I love Burmese. I'm such a great one myself. Oh dear. Right, battle number 4, let us go for. Let's go for Psychic this time, so we can at least use a different move other than Thunderbolt. Oh dear. Right, now I don't believe there is a Psychic Water type, is there? Off the top of my head, I can't think of one. Honestly, I don't know whether there is a Psychic Water type. Yeah. Now, I don't remember whether it is 7 or 10 battles that you need to win in this one. So what I think I'm going to do is probably get to 7 wins, and if the challenge isn't like completed by then, I think I'm just going to, you know, quit out this challenge, right? And let's go with flying. Third. Now, I believe, like, well, you can enter with one Pokemon more than once, obviously. And then, like, the challenges that, like, you chose last time, I guess, like the ranks, they will stay from last time, so, yeah. So say we got to, like, rank 2 in normal with Janelle here. I don't know why I said it as that instead of just Janelle. But yeah, if we got to rank 2 with Janelle in normal, and then like one set of the challenges, and then we came back for the second round of challenges, the normal type would still stay at rank 2. Whee! What else is weak to electric? I think is that literally it, flying and water? Nice. Sure, let's go with an ice type, why not? Even though we're weak against ice. Hold on, incoming text message. That guy sounds suspiciously like me when I'm recording. smooch. Oh wow, it's actually perfect. Part psychic as well. Perfect for old Janelle here. I'm gonna say old, she's not old. Bless her. Yeah. Now, was that battle number 6 or was it battle number 7? I don't remember. I don't know. But you know what I think I'm gonna do? I think I may just like shorten the other two facilities other than the battle tower. And then like shove those in the beginning of one episode or the next episode. And then just like extend the Battle Tower one to that, because like I said, unless you only need to win 7 battles for this challenge, I am just going to cut it short now. Well, not now, after this one, you know what I mean. Right, is this Dratini going to go down? It does, perfect. So that would be our 7th win now. She said, "You're kidding me, am I right?" Sure, I guess. Ah, dear. Ah, right. Okay, then, so you do need to win 10 battles, so I'm just gonna retire and then just, well, walk out. Speaking of incoming text messages... Oh dear. Right. Sorry, I'm trying to... Hey! Right. Okay. Yeah, for each of the facilities, you get different... Oops, I do not wish to start another challenge in here. Yeah, for each of the facilities, you will get a different number of, like, battle points for when you... But when you complete the challenge, like for this battle hall, you only get one. Which I suppose I kind of understand because it's really easy. Or really easy in the beginning. But yeah. So I believe that's going to be it for this episode. So thank you for watching. Make sure you subscribe to stay up to date with the rest of my videos. And I will see you guys next time for what may be the last episode of Pokemon Platinum Randomizer. Oh, how emotional. See you then. I'm gonna go get some more.